Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can perform linear search in C programming. Right? So before starting explanation, I just want to give you one information. If you go to detail or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists. So you can watch those programs if you want to learn programming. Now I'm going to explain how we can perform linear search with the help of a C program. So first I'm going to read an array, and then I'm going to read a number that we want to search in that particular array. So let me draw one array here. So let's say this is 1D array. These are indexes. And its name is A. And these are indices, right? And these are the values which are assigned into this array. So first we are going to read this array from the code, and then we are going to read a number. Let's say I want to search 15. So I need to identify whether 15 is available in this 1D array or not, or we can also identify on which location it is available, right? And let's say first we will check it for 15 and then we will check it for 25. So if n is 25, so you can see 25 is not available in this array. So in that case, the program should print the number is not found, right? So the program should be printing both the results. If it is available, then it will say number is present at this location. And if the number is not available, then it should say number is not present, right? So now I am going to implement the solution. So first of all, I am going to declare an array. Then the number which we want to search, then variable I. And I am using a flag variable that is f, whose initial value is 0. Then after this, I am going to write printf, which will display a message. Enter 10 numbers. Then with the help of for loop, I am going to read all those numbers. So for loop will repeat this scanf. And all the numbers will be stored inside this array, right? Now, after this, I'm going to write one more printf, and it will display the message, enter the number to be searched. So user has to enter the number that he want to search in the array, and then to receive that as input, I am writing this. So this part will read array, and this part will read the number that you want to search, whether it is present inside array or not. Right? So this is quite easy. So I hope you understood till now whatever is implemented. So now I am going to write the code that will perform linear search. So I hope you also understood why it is called linear search, because we are searching from the first number, and we are going to search that number till end. So linearly we are going to search that number one by one, if it is available or not. And if it is available on a particular position, then we need to break the rotation of loop, or you can say we need to break the searching process, so that unnecessarily we don't match the number which we are going to search with other numbers, right? So after this, I'm going to write one more loop. So this will also repeat 10 times, because we don't know whether number will be available or not. But if inside this loop, anytime number is found, we can break the loop with the help of break keyword. So now with this loop, first I'm going to write if condition. So if A of I double equals to N. So A of I means element of array, and N is the variable which is having the number which we want to search, right? So in first go, In first go, whenever anyone implemented this solution, so they may be thinking like, if it is true, then we can print number is found, and if it is false, then we can print number is not found. Right? So in first go, you might be thinking like, we can implement this solution like this, but it is incorrect. So I am repeating, it is incorrect. So now I am telling you why it is incorrect. So let's say number is 15. I am going to search 15, and these are the elements of array, right? So loop will start from 0. So first it will check A0. So A0 location is having 11. So first it will check 11 double equals to 15. So this condition is false. So it will print not found, right? Then again I will be incremented. I will become 1. So A of one position is having 12. So 12 is again not equals to 15. Then again it will print not found. So for 11, 12, 13, 14, it will print not found. Then in case of 15, it will print found. And for again 5 numbers, it will print not found. So it means this process is incorrect. So I am removing these statements. So I hope you understood. Inside this loop, we cannot print whether number is present or not. We can just identify whether it is present or not. So now I am going to use this variable inside this loop. So if this condition is true, then I am changing the value of flag. So initially it was 0. If this condition is true, then I am changing its value with 1. And if this condition is true, it means number is present. So we can break the loop. So we can break the loop. And I am closing the loop. So you can see, I have not mentioned anywhere inside this loop with the help of printf, like number is found or not found. I just changed the value of f variable with 1. Initially, it was 0. So now, again, I am going to test this. With same number, like number is 15 and array is containing these values. So first time when A0 will be checked, so A0 is having 11. 11 double equals to 15. So condition is false. So we are having only true part for if. We are not having any else part. So if this condition is false, then control will be transferred to I++. So I will be 1. So next time A1, that is 12. So 12 will be compared with 15. So 12 and 15 both are unequal. So again, it will be false. So I will be incremented. So this way 13 will be false. 14 will be false. When 15 comes, so 15, A of I is having 15, N is having 15. So both are true. In that case, F will become 1 and break will terminate this loop. So after this, after execution of this break, this loop will not work and control will be transferred here just after the loop. It means if this condition is true, then f will be having 1, right? And if f is having 1, it means number is found. So after this loop, you just need to implement one if, and you need to check what is the value of f. So let's say if f double equals to 1, if f double equals to 1, or you can write simply f. Inside if, you can write f double equals to 1, or you can simply write f. Because f is containing 1, so any non-zero value in programming is considered as true. So here you can write printf, number is found. Number is found. And else you can print number is not found, and you can close your main function, right? So now you might be thinking, when value of f will become 0, right? So if we take 25 as value of n, so we want to search 25 inside this array. So you can see 25 is not present. It means this if condition will not become true anytime. So this loop will repeat 10 times, and all 10 times this if will be false. So if this condition is false, then f will not become 1 anytime, right? So all 10 rotations, if we are performing all 10 rotations, this if condition is false, so what will be the value of f? 1 or 0? It will be 0, because if is not true. So if this condition is not true, it means we are not changing the value of f. So it will remain 0. And after completion of this loop, if f is not equals to 1, it means it is 0. So it will print number is not. Right? So if f is 1, it means number is available. Otherwise, number is not available. So this way, with this condition, we are able to identify whether a number is found inside array or not. Now, one more thing is remaining. So it is printing number is found, but it is not printing at which location. It is not printing at which location. So now what you can do, let's say number is 15. So 15 is present at this location. And at that time, value of I was 4. A4 location, fourth index is having 15. And 15 was equals to 15. So f was 1 and loop terminated using break. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this location is 5th, but its index is 4 and loop is terminated. So last value of I was 4 when number was found. So here you can print number is found at %d location. And then you can print I plus 1. So I was 4. So we are printing 4 plus 1. So the output will be number is found at 5th location. Number is found at 5th location. So this way you can add like at which location number is available with the help of I. So this way the program that I explained to implement linear search, so that we can find whether a particular number is available in an array or not. And one more thing you need to notice, let's say 15 is available one more time in this array. So in this program, we are only finding the first occurrence of that number. So 15 is available at this position, it means it is found. So no need to check any other occurrence of this number. So if array is containing all elements as 15, let's say all elements are 15. So if at first position 15 is available, so no need to check other elements whether they are 15 or not. So this way, in case of linear search, you just need to find out whether that number is available at initial positions or not. If it is available, then no need to search for another positions. And if it is not available, then in that case, you need to search for all the elements, because maybe it is available at last location. So you need to rotate all, you need to check all the elements in the loop rotation. And I also explained the use of break. So I hope you understood why we implemented break here, so that we can terminate the process. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.